colors, is that there will be so much wealth before the end of time that man will take a handful of gold or silver and he will look for people to accept this from him and he will not find anybody who will accept this from him. Adi ibn Hatim radiallahu ta'ala anhu relates a hadith. فبينما أنا عند النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم إذ أتاه رجل فشكى إليه الفاقة. That we were in the company of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم when a man came and complained about poverty and starvation. Another man came to Nabi عليه الصلاة والسلام and complained about highway robbers. Nabi صلى الله عليه وسلم said to Adi ibn Hatim رضي الله تعالى عنه كهو حديث هل رأيت الحيرة؟ وعدي have you seen حيرة؟ سيدنا عدي بن حاتم رضي الله تعالى عنه replied يا رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم لم أرها وقد أنبئت عنها. I've not seen حيرة. حيرة is a city in كوفة which is in Iraq, modern day Iraq. ونبي صلى الله عليه وسلم I've not seen حيرة but I've been informed about it. نبي صلى الله عليه وسلم said to عدي ولئن طالت بك حياة لترين الضعين ترتحل من الحيرة حتى تطوف بالكعبة لا تخاف أحدا إن الله. وعدي الله gives you a long life. A day will come in which you will see a lovely young woman. She will travel by herself all the way from Hira in Iraq, and she will come to the house of Allah, and she will make tawaf of the house of Allah, and she will fear no dacoit, she will fear no highway robbers, she will fear nobody besides Allah subhanahu wa taala. نبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال وعدي ولئن طالت بك حياة لتفتحن كنوز كسرى. If Allah gives you a long life, you will see that the treasures of Kisra are open. وعدي, if Allah gives you a long life, you will see that a man will come out with a handful of gold or silver and he will be looking for people to take this gold and silver from him. He will find nobody that will be in need of this gold and silver. عدي بن حاتم رضي الله تعالى عنه says the prophecies and the predictions of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam I saw with my very own eyes. A time had come when there was so much peace and security that a woman would travel all the way from Hira by herself fearing no highway robbers, and she would come and she would perform Umrah, she would make tawaf around the house of Allah and she would return by herself. He says, as for the treasures of Kisra, I was from amongst those people who conquered Persia and we took the treasures and the booty from Persia. And he says, O Muslim, if Allah gives you a long life, you will see the day when a man will come out with a handful of gold or silver looking for people to accept it from him, and he will not find a single person to accept it from him. Some scholars are of the opinion that this also took place at the time of Umar ibn Abdul Aziz. At the time of Umar ibn Abdul Aziz, there was so much wealth that a man would come out with a handful of gold and silver, but he would not find any needy man. He would find nobody in need of zakat, nobody in need of sadaqah, nobody in need of this wealth. We will see this happen again at the time of Imam Mahdi and at the time of Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam. There will be so much wealth in their time that the earth will take out its treasures and the earth will take out its barakah, and nobody will be in need of sadaqah and zakah. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, تقيو الأرض أفلاس كبدها أمثال الأسطوان من الذهب والفضة. That the earth will vomit long pieces of its liver like columns of gold and silver. A murderer will come when he sees this gold and silver, he will say, في هذا قتل, did I kill for this? One who broke his family ties because of wealth, he will come and say, في هذا قطعت رحمي, did I break relations because of this? A thief will come and say, في هذا قطع, was my hand cut off because of this? And none of them will touch this gold and silver, and they will leave it. Another sign that has not appeared is that the Euphrates will disclose a mountain of gold. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, إلا تقوم الساعة حتى يحصر الفرات عن جبل من ذهب يقتفل الناس عليه. That Qiyamah will not come till the river Euphrates will disclose a mountain of gold. People will fight over this gold. Out of every 199 will be killed. And every man will say to himself, لعلي أكون أنا الذي أنجو. it is possible that I am the one that will survive. The river Euphrates is a river which runs from Syria and Iraq and empties in the Gulf. Before the end of time, this river will disclose a mountain of gold. And people will fight for this gold. As for how this river will disclose a mountain of gold, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows best. But one thing Nabi alayhi salatu wa salam has definitely told the Muslims is, كَمَنْ حَظَرْ فَلَا يَأْخُذْ مِنْهُ شَيْئًا. Whoever is alive at the time and present when this river discloses a mountain of gold, he should not touch it and he should not take anything from it. Another thing that I like to mention here is that this hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is authentic. There is no doubt in the hadith of Rasulullah. But there are people in this day and age which find it difficult to believe in this hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and they interpret this hadith as referring to not gold but to oil. This is completely wrong, because the words of the hadith are Jabalun, which is mountain in Arabic. For anybody that knows basic Arabic will tell you the word Jabal means mountain. And the word Zahab means gold. Gold is not called oil and oil is not called gold. Secondly, if this hadith of Rasulullah was referring to oil, then what would be so special about the river Euphrates? Oil already comes out of land. It already comes out of water. So there would be nothing special if this hadith was referring to oil. And thirdly, Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam has said that people will fight over this mountain of gold. In history, never has anybody fought over oil coming out from the river Euphrates or any other place. As for this, a mountain will come out, a mountain of gold, and people will fight over it. Another sign that we have still not seen is the wind which will come from Sham, a cool breeze. It will enter the armpit of every Muslim, whereby every Muslim will die. In the long hadith regarding the Dajjal, in this hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, after mentioning the killing of Dajjal, how Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam will kill the Dajjal, in this hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, thereafter Nabi alayhi salatu wa sallam mentioned that the Muslims will remain for 7 years. لَيْتَ بَيْنَ إِثْنَيْنِ عَدَاوَةٌ. There will be no enmity between two Muslims. Then Allah will send this cool breeze from Sham, and it will enter the armpit of every Muslim and it will extract his soul. No Muslims will remain. To the extent that if a Muslim enters the cave of a mountain, the wind will follow and take out his soul. In a lot of the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we can say that this wind, this cool breeze which will come from Sham, will appear when all the major signs have appeared. And after this wind, the worst of humankind, the worst of mankind will remain. Hafiz ibn Hajar al-Asqalani writes, reports a tradition which means that a woman will pass by a group of men. One of the men will raise her garment just like the tail of a sheep is raised, and he will commit zina with her in the public. A man will say from amongst them, only if you had gone behind the tree or behind some wall. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says that this man will be like Abu Bakr and Umar amongst you. This is a sign that has not appeared to this very day. Another sign that has not appeared to this very day is a great war which will take place between the Muslims and the Christians. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, count and prepare for 6 things before Qiyamah. And one of the things Nabi alayhi salatu wa sallam mentioned was a peace treaty between the Muslims and the Christians. Then he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that the Christians will break this peace and they will come with 80 flags. On the east flag they will have 12,000 men. As for what will happen in this war, Usayr ibn Jabir radiallahu ta'ala anhu relates, في حاجة ريوح حمراء بالكوفة. Once there was a sandstorm in Kufa, and a man came repeating the words, Ya Abdullah ibn Mas'ud ja'at isa', Ya Abdullah ibn Mas'ud ja'at isa'. Ya Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, the hour has come. Abdullah ibn Mas'ud sat up and said, إن الساعة لا تقوم حتى لا يقسم ميراث ولا يفرح بغنيمته. That Qiyamah will not come till heritage is not divided, and there will be no rejoicing over mali ghanimat, over booty. Then he said, عدو يجمعون لأهل الإسلام ويجمع لهم أهل الإسلام. But the enemy will muster strong against the Muslims, and the Muslims will muster strong against the enemy. The narrator says, I asked, are you referring to the Christians? He said, yes. There will be a great fight between the Muslims and Christians. The hadith states, فَيَشْتَرِتُ الْمُسْلِمُونَ شَرْطَةً لِلْمَوْتِ لَا تَرْجُوا إِلَّا غَالِبًا فَيَقْتَتِلُونَ حَتَّى يَحْجِزَ بَيْنَهُمُ اللَّيْلِ فَيُفِيعُ هَؤُلَاءِ وَهَؤُلَاءِ كُلَّ غَيْرَ غَالِبٍ وَتَفْنَى الشَّرْطَةِ. So the Muslims and Christians will fight. The Muslims will select a detachment which will fight, and promises that will keep on fighting till it dies or it will return victorious.